Good morning, afternoon, evening, whatever time of day we are worshiping together, and however we are worshiping. If you are on your phone, a tablet, a computer, or a television set, we are glad that we can spend this time together in worship. We have some announcements at Good Shepherd. Coming up, we have my son, Micah. His baptism is October the 10th. That's going to be at 9:30 in the sanctuary. And afterward, there's going to be a reception. You're invited. It's going to be at the poolside at Marin Country Club. So please come and be part of that. It's going to be a very exciting and meaningful day. That is October the 10th. Also coming up, we have First Communion classes. That's for second grade on up to adults. So if you want to learn more about communion, we are going to meet in the sanctuary October the 20th and 27th from 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock. And then we will come forward on Reformation Sunday. It's also Halloween. And we will come forward and have our first communion. That will be October 31st, which is also Reformation Sunday. And be part of that. It's a very meaningful time. So if it's something you'd like to do with your children or grandchildren, that you'd like to do this together, it's particularly powerful and special. If you have questions that you'd like to know more about joining Good Shepherd Church or about baptism, please contact me. And as we get ready to prepare our hearts for worship, let's take a moment to just plant our feet on the ground, sit up a little straighter wherever you are. Take some deep breaths into your abdomen and kind of out of your throat and be here and try and set aside the busyness of the past or the plans for the future. Amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. Hallelujah, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. This is a gathering prayer. It's going to be in unison. This comes from our fourth grade class, which their chapel service meets at 10:15 on Wednesday. Their chapel job for the fourth grade is to come forward and bring the class prayer. And we pray this together, our third, fourth, and fifth grade in our chapel service. This is from Mrs. Gibson's fourth grade class this week, September 29th at Good Shepherd. Let us pray together. Dear God, thank you for the warmth of the sunshine and our families. We hope that everyone can work together to stop world hunger. We hope children can soon get the COVID vaccine. We pray for rain and for our drought to stop and no more wildfires. We are so thankful for the food on the table, the houses we live in. And finally, we hope that people will learn to always see the positive side of all things and remember that God always loves us, no matter what. Amen. And let's take a time where we come to God. This is a unison prayer of confession and wholeness. It's a prayer where we lift off the burdens of our heart. It's in the burdens that we lift off that we're asking God to work for ways of forgiveness and reconciliation and peace and name the things that we have said or not said, done or not done. And it's in that that we can truly be in the world as forgiven children of God. Let us pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may protect, love you, and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to a moment of silent prayer and confession. Friends, in the Word who has come to dwell with us, God has given us grace upon grace, forgiveness that is stronger than our sins, love that can heal every broken heart. In the name of Jesus, our Savior, we are free from all of our sins. Amen.
lift your name on high.
Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you.
Created by you, let us live in your image. Created for you, let us act for your glory. Redeemed by you, let us give you what is yours. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 2 through 10. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers constantly, remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor, of love and steadfastness, of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that he has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with full conviction. Just as you know what kind of person we proved to be among you for your sake, and you became imitators of us and of the Lord. For in spite of persecution, you received the word with joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit, so that you became an example to all the believers in Macedonia and in Achaia. For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report among us what kind of welcome we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve a living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescues us from the wrath that is coming. This is the word of God.
Today's gospel reading comes to us from the book of Matthew, chapter 22, verses 15 through 22, and it's a teaching about an emperor and God. Then the Pharisees went and plotted to entrap Jesus in what he said. So they sent their disciples to him, along with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are sincere and teach the way of God in accordance with the truth, and show deference to no one, for you do not regard people with partiality. Tell us then, what do you think? Is it lawful to pay taxes to the emperor or not?" But Jesus, aware of their malice, said, Why are you putting me to the test, you hypocrites? Show me the coin used for the tax. And they brought him a denarius. Then he said to them, Whose head is this, and whose title? They answered, The emperor's. Then he said to them, Give therefore to the emperor the things that are the emperor's, and to God the things that are God's. When they heard this, they were amazed. They left him and went away. The grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of God endures forever. Thanks be to God.
Boys and girls, well, hey, it's so good to see you. I look forward to seeing you every single week. Do you know how I come in and sometimes we've talked about really wonderful things that God does, right? Well, something happened to me. Something happened to me that made it really wonderful. And it happened in a real surprise. And I was like, oh my gosh. I found out that my wife, she's pregnant with another baby.
So
I'm going to be a daddy again. And I just found out. It's a miracle. I can't believe it. I just found out. And I don't know if it's a boy or a girl. We don't know yet. So
I think it's going to be a boy.
You think it'll be a boy?
I think it's going to be a girl.
You think it'll be a girl?
I don't know which one.
Yeah, now, I have black eye, black hair. And my wife has black hair, too. Do you think the baby will maybe have black hair? Or you think we'll have blonde hair?
My dad has black hair.
You have black hair?
I have blonde.
You have blonde. I have straight hair.
My dad has spiky hair.
Spiky hair? I have straight black hair. And my wife has straight black hair. Do you think it'll be straight or curly?
My dad has dark hair.
Dark hair.
And I have brown hair.
Well, I am so happy to hear this news. I want to share it with you so that God works in ways that can be really amazing. And when you go home and talk to your moms and dads, I want you to talk to them about what are amazing ways that you see God. So how have you had a God sighting? Where have you seen God? Remember we talked about a God sighting? Will they ask me something? What is it?
Is this brown?
I would say your hair is brown. That's brown. That's brown and blonde. And mine's brown, but it's pretty dark.
What color is
mine? And your hair is black for sure.
Mine's brown.
Yeah.
Mine's
what is it? Nice. What's your
name? My hair is blonde.
Nicholas.
Nicholas. What is it?
I have to ask one question.
What's the question?
My dad, he's
going to
pick me up today.
Uh-huh. What's your daddy's name?
Grown-ups usually call him Colin.
Colin. You've got a good dad.
And my
tell me your name
is
again.
Timmy.
What is it?
Timmy.
What is it?
When I'm baking, I'll buy a garbage truck, a grader, an ATV, and a monster truck, and a grader.
Would you take me with you on your monster truck and your ATV?
Yeah.
Oh, and a garbage truck, too.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Harrison.
Harrison, okay. Yeah, two questions.
Okay, I'll do the one question and then that.
Yes.
So my dad has but he can't go on.
What's your second question? That is? Blonde. Yeah. Tell me your name again.
Alan.
Alan. And what's your question?
The question is, I have three pets and one dog.
Nice. How fun to have pets. And what's your name? Tell me again.
I don't have Harry.
What's your name?
And I have a
what
DJ
is it?
Scale. Harry. And I have DJ
Hold on,
Calla.
Hold on. What is it?
And my guinea pig's name
fluffy.
And my piggy is.
And your toes are like.
What is it?
When I was at the park, I used to see when my nephew was. My sissy felt.
You know what? I want to thank all of you because you're really good at raising your hands, asking questions, and thank you for listening to my news that I wanted to share that God's working in ways for me too, and I had a God sighting. So when you go home to your moms and dads, talk to them and ask them, where did they have a God sighting today? Yes, Harrison. When you see God in some...
I'm going to be an angel.
You be an angel? What's your name?
I'm not an angel.
Yeah, what's your question?
I'm not an angel. I need to...
Uh-oh. Hold on. Shh. Yeah?
And I got a pink and green
phone. Did you?
I said an angel.
Yes.
I need to tell you something.
If you don't want to talk to your mom and dad about God, you can't.
No, your mom and dad will love to hear what you think.
You
what would you like to share?
When me and my sister were in my sister playground, because my dad picked us to find acorns for school, Legos, but we actually didn't. And what happened, we found...
Fun. Would you do an echo prayer with me? Let's put our hands together. Oh, that's not nice. Put our hands together. Okay, your hands together. Okay, hands together. Echo prayer. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you for making.
Thank you for making.
God sightings.
God sightings.
In my life.
In my life.
And other people.
And other people.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, boys and girls. It's so good to see all of you. So go.
Friends, please pray with me. Loving God, may the meditation of all of our hearts, our word read and proclaimed, our songs sung, our prayers prayed, our fellowship, restore us and renew us. Make us the lights of Christ you call us to be in our lives and in our world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We have some beautiful passages from 1 Thessalonians, we have a passage from Matthew, and we have a passage from Isaiah. And our passage from Matthew is certainly a timely topic, talking about taxes, of all things, and paying taxes. So one can't help but smile at the current event relevance of it all, and I was talking with some Lutheran ministers, and we had a big laugh on the timeliness of it. And we are remembering the quote from G.K. Chesterton, who says, "I like paying taxes because it buys me civilization." And with that in mind, it's an important passage when we look at relationships of our faith and then in the society and governments where we live. And whatever those are, God is still calling us to be people of faith in whatever system or society or whatever government we are currently living in. But I want to draw our attention to the Isaiah passage because there's something in that that I think resonates with each of us. And it's the Isaiah, and it comes in line number 3. And Isaiah writes, "I will give you the treasures of darkness and the riches hidden in secret places." And often in life, when we are experiencing darkness, when we are lost in some way, trying to find our way emotionally, psychologically, spiritually, the last thing we think of darkness is that it's a treasure. In fact, it's the furthest thing from our reality. It can be a nightmare or horrible, frustrating at best. But when we are called, when we are trying to find our vocation and our ways in life, the setbacks and the falling downs, sometimes those are the things, places where we learn and we can grow the most. One of the things that we can do a disservice to our children is when we only talk about our successes and we only point to these past things that we've done. And then the end of the story is, and I was successful. What we leave out to our children were the roadblocks, the falling down, the disappointments, the closed doors. And it was in those experiences that God further called us, ultimately, to where we would be. And those darknesses become the very places that shape us, that give us courage, that give us direction. So when Isaiah writes about darkness as a treasure, I find that rich and fascinating and hopeful for many of us. Many of us are going through huge life changes right now. Employment, to relocations, to empty nest, children now, instead of going to college, staying at home. And the list just goes on and on and on. A COVID-19 vaccine, who knows when that's going to come about? We hear things, it seems like every day on the news. Maybe this year, maybe it's going to be 2021, maybe longer than that. We don't know. But in the meantime, our lives are being lived right now. And we are going through much, much change in our life. And this passage from Isaiah can be a signpost for us as we discern the many changes in our own lives. Where will I be in that question that I've never personally liked that question? Where will I be in 5 years? whatever answer I give, but in reality, I don't know. And that's what I find exciting about life. I just don't know. And it's in these dark places that we can stumble and fall. And God is leading us there too. And look back at your own life and honestly look at where you fell, where the door closed, disappointments mounted, frustrations. Often that's the very place where God starts kind of leading you. And it is essential to have those experiences because it got you to where you're going. You know, there's the song that many of you probably know from Rascal Flatts that is popularized called God Bless the Broken Road That Led Me Straight to You. And it's in that kind of broken road metaphor that's rich and fertile soil. Rich and fertile ground for each of us. And with that in mind, and when we look to these other passages from 1 Thessalonians, you know, Paul is once again kind of writing to another community, and there's conflict there. He's having to kind of re-explain some of his message to people. Or we look at the tensions between faith life and secular government in Matthew. And how do we hold all of these places? And what we can knit together in each of these passages is that God is caring and guiding us through when we are in turmoil, maybe in a church setting or in a social setting, whatever that might be. Remember back to the Isaiah passage about the treasures of darkness. And when we have those dark moments, something, if we can be mindful, is instead of looking at it as an affliction, maybe it's something else altogether. Maybe it is a signpost. Maybe it's a place where you're called to be. When I can certainly go on, even becoming a minister. I can tell you, I won't go into every detail, but the path on my road to becoming a minister is chock full of disappointments, of places where I thought I should be, I thought society wanted me to be, where my ego suggested I should be, a number of those places. And all of those were met with heartbreak and disappointment and setbacks. But in the end, all those very things were the things that were needed to get me to where God was wanting me to get to. And when I turned my head in that direction, I got nothing but green lights. And that's something to think about for each of us. Look at your own life. Look back over the landscape of your life and where your disappointments were. And instead of being crushed by the disappointment, how was it that you weathered the disappointment? And ultimately, where did you land? And how is that a saving and gracious place to be? My friends, this is something we can all kind of walk gently into. We can treat our fellow human beings with some kindness, knowing that they're probably going through some of these things too. It helps us to find compassion in people. Right now, more than ever, when we have these great divisions that are in our society right now, it's easy to reduce people, to minimize people, make them out to be enemies, make them out to be dumber, make them out to be a number of different things. But instead of going down that road, maybe we can be a little bit gentler with people, a little bit kinder, and knowing that they might be trying to find the treasures of darkness as well. And that may make each of us just a little more compassionate. And that's not such a bad thing right now. A little more of that in our life and our world. May it be so for each of you, and also very much for me. Amen. Thank you, band. Let's join together in unison for our Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. Friends, this is a time where we come to God in prayer for our life, prayer for our worship. We'd like to lift up prayers for Jenny Wiley. She is a third grade teacher at Good Shepherd Lutheran School, and she has taken at least six weeks for a fairly significant surgery, and she will be recovering. So prayers for Jenny Wiley and her family as she recovers, and for our new substitute teacher, Christina Silva, who has come in. So prayers for our third grade class. And also continued prayers of resurrection for Tricia Hader. Tricia's son, Jim, is planned to service on October the 16th. It's going to be 11:30 here in the sanctuary, and you are invited to attend that service of resurrection. May children and heirs of God's promise, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Holy One, you have raised up faithful leaders throughout history. Empower those discerning a call to ministry and all seminarians that they continue to be formed for the sake of the gospel. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have established a diverse and beautiful creation. Revive declining species, preserve endangered lands, cultivate in us a sense of wonder for the world you created. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You desire for us not to be alone and to live in community with one another. Strengthen relationship between nations and peoples that we celebrate and support one human family. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You share in our experiences and struggles. Bless all who live with many mental and physical disability. Inspire creative communities, spaces, and environments that are accessible and hospitable. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have established and nurtured relationships that extended beyond those gathered here today. Bless members who can no longer travel or worship with us. Remind us of their continued role in this community of faith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You promise eternal life for all your children. Thank you for the people of faith who have gone before us. Strengthen our trust we have in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known only to you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And friends, now we turn to one another and pass the peace of Christ. If you'd like to send new pictures in, we would love to get new photographs from you. Email them to the church office. New photographs for our passing of the peace. We want to see what you are up to these days. So please share with us. Let's turn to one another and pass the peace of Christ and say, God loves you. There's nothing you can do about it. Amen. Friends, this is a time for our communion when we gather together. We'd like you to know that we have blessed elements that can be delivered to your home, or you can come to the church and pick them up. As we prepare our hearts for communion, you can gather, you can get some wine or juice, get some bread or a cracker, and gather around your communion table as we prepare our hearts for this meal and to thank God for the gift of this presence of His Spirit in bread and wine. People will come from the east and the west and the north and the south. They will come from Sausalito and Santa Rosa and Point Richmond and Novato to sit at the table of the kingdom of God. When our risen Lord was at table with His disciples, He took the bread and blessed it and broke it, and their eyes were opened and they recognized Him. Friends, this is the most generous invitation that we can make in our tradition, and all are welcome to this table. If you've been baptized in Christ, you are welcome to this table. If you've been seeking to know Christ, you are welcome to this table. All can come to this table, no matter where you're born, how much money you make, or who you love. God be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore, with thanksgiving and unending joy, we echo on earth the song of the angels in heaven as they praise your glory forever. Friends, let's join together in the perfect prayer that Jesus taught his disciples, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. When Christ was with the disciples at the table, he took the bread and blessed it, and broke it, and said, This is my body given to you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same way, he took the cup and poured it, and said, This is the new covenant that's sealed in my blood, that's shed for the forgiveness of sins. And every time you drink from this cup and you eat from this loaf, you proclaim the living Lord. My friends, these are the gifts of God, and all of you are the people of God. Please pray with me. Holy and compassionate God, in bread and wine, you give us gifts that form us to be both humble and courageous. May your words come to life in our serving and in our witness, that we might speak a living voice of healing and justice to all the world, through Jesus Christ, our rock and our Redeemer. Amen. And as we prepare our hearts to go out into the world, let's continue to pray. We thank you, living God, for your Son who sustains us in the wilderness and the garden alike. As Christ has loved us, so send us to love Christ and our neighbors. And finally, let us pray for all who have contracted the coronavirus, for those who are particularly vulnerable, for all who experience fear and anxiety, for families who are facing difficult decisions between food on the table or public safety, for those who do not have adequate health insurance, for those who were afraid to access care due to immigration status, for public officials and decision makers.
Grant
peace,
grant
comfort, grant healing, grant wisdom, grant enough. May we, your church, be a sign of hope, comfort, and love to all. Amen.
Spirit said the blessing.
And friends, receive the benediction as we go out into today, into this week, into this life. And go with God's grace. And never sell yourself short. Risk something big for something good. Know that our world is too dangerous for anything but truth. And it's too small for anything but love. Let's all go in peace. Amen. Friends, go in peace and show the love of God.
beautiful.